Thank you very much. Dear colleagues, in my paper I will present one of the under-researched topics of the history after the Second World War in Trieste and the surrounding area, namely the question of Slovene refugee women in Trieste in the first years after the war. I will give special attention to the jobs performed by these women. I will focus on those which worked as teachers. Due to the very strong politicization of cultural life and the politicization among Slovenes in post-war Trieste at the time, the topic remains under research. The role of the said refugee women in Trieste remains quite unknown. We need obviously an introduction in order to understand the topic. So the context that Professor Marta Verginella has already presented. In the fascist era, the legislation had detrimental effects on all vital Slovene structures, including culture, toponyms, personal names, surnames, publications, the economy, politics, various associations, and obviously the school system. In the second half of the 20s, the schools were completely Italianized. Some underground courses were preserved, but we can say that the school system was completely abolished. The situation started changing after September 1943. Despite the difficult context, the partisan movement opened some Slovene schools. And also, the German authorities gave the possibility to open Slovene schools, but the majority of Slovenes reject this possibility. Also, a few experiences of schools self-organized by women are known. For instance, in Udine, na Brežina. These were not supported by the partisan movement. Therefore, also in the case of extraction, there was not the possibility of collaboration between the parts. And this difficulty to meet persists after the war. Immediately after the liberation in 1945, the partisan movement organized the school system in opposition to the Allied military government. Obviously, we speak about the Zone A. In fact, the Anglo-American authorities in this zone nominated opponents of the new Tito's Yugoslavia to the leading positions of the schools. The opponents were predominantly refugees from which arrived after the war in Trieste. Among them were also Slovenes. Obviously, they left or fled Yugoslavia for political reasons. This was a great opportunity for Allied military government in order to eliminate communist or pro-Yugoslav influence in the schools. Very fierce controversy reached the peak when the person responsible for the Slovenian schools in the zone, Srečko Baraga, was sentenced in absence to death by the authorities in Ljubljana in February 1946. Obviously, the problem of the schools was strictly linked to the border question, not still solved at the time. I analyzed unpublished primary sources held by the former Yugoslav and the United States archives and also newspapers and specialized scholarly literature. I made a calculation regarding the number of these Slovene refugees. Totally, there were between 700 and 800. The total number among them of women is not known, but comparison of various data permits us to have the basic information of 74 women. The name, surname, the date and place of birth, and their job after the war in Trieste. The majority of them, the majority were teachers, 51. Some of them remained in Trieste for some years and then left for other places. More or less, the numbers of the so-called partisan teachers were the same. Additionally, the so-called partisan teachers, women teachers, were the same. Additionally, in the documents of Slovene organizations, some teachers, women teachers, have been marked politically undefined. The numbers varied because some of the so-called partisan teachers lost their job, and among them were some women. In any case, they received a salary from the authorities in Ljubljana. In fact, even for some time, some Slovenian schools acted without permission from the Alice. On the other part, in some schools with allied permission, some teachers, and among them were women teachers, even used unauthorized textbooks that had, they had pictures of Tito on the walls and so on. In that disobedience, women, so-called partisan teachers, were engaged the same as men. In the Slovene archives, there are also lists regarding the so-called partisan women teachers, other lists. Among the most interesting are data regarding their status, married or unmarried or widows. More or less, the numbers of married and unmarried were the same. Meanwhile, there were few widows. In some documents, we can also find that there were indications that some women teachers spoke poorly Slovenian language. Obviously, it will be interesting a comparison with the situation in Carinthia and Istria. Unfortunately, we have very few information. We know that Slovene refugees organized their schools in refugee camps in Carinthia. It is worth noting that a part of them was moved into other refugee camps in the center of Italy, and after some weeks or some months, some of them moved to Trieste. About Istria, I tried to find cases of women teachers in the zone B, Istria, on the list of epuration. On that list are 215 persons, and among them 15 women. Unfortunately, we have no information if they were teachers during the past time. During the fascism or the war. Obviously fascist schools. On the other part, on the list of epuration for Trieste, we can find 43 teachers and among them 11 women, but no one was Slovene. Regarding the Slovene women teachers in Trieste region, and with this I shall finish my contribution, I can conclude that the engagement of both sides was very big. In fact, both sides were very determined to prove their right, and the field of school and teaching was one of the most hot, if I may say. As a consequence, this led to a strong antagonism which lasted for a long time. This reflected also to the reconstructions. In the reconstructions written by some of the protagonists of the period. This is also one of the reasons why these questions, especially the role of women teachers, were never deeply studied. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Gorazd, also for leaving so generously your part of your time for.